In the annals of history, there exists a tale of a young man whose name would reverberate through the ages as one of the most remarkable conquerors the world has ever seen, Alexander the Great. Born in 356 BCE in the ancient kingdom of Macedonia, Alexander was destined for greatness from the moment he drew his first breath. Alexander's father, King Philip II, recognized his son's potential and provided him with the finest education under the guidance of the philosopher Aristotle. As a result, Alexander developed a keen intellect, a thirst for knowledge, and a desire to surpass even the loftiest of ambitions. In 336 BCE, tragedy struck when King Philip was assassinated, leaving the throne to a 20-year-old Alexander. The new king quickly asserted his authority, consolidating his power within his kingdom and quelling any potential rebellion. But Alexander's ambitions stretched far beyond the borders of Macedonia. With a meticulously crafted strategy, he set his sights on the Persian Empire, a sprawling dominion that encompassed lands from modern-day Greece to India. In 334 BCE, Alexander crossed the Hellespont with an army of around 40,000 men, embarking on a campaign that would soon become the stuff of legend. At the Battle of Granicus, Alexander's tactical brilliance shone as his forces defeated the Persian satraps, sending shockwaves through the empire. As he marched further into Persian territory, city after city fell before his army's might. The decisive victory at the Battle of Issus in 333 BCE saw Alexander personally engage and defeat the Persian king Darius III, solidifying his reputation as a warrior without equal. The pursuit of Darius continued, leading to the Battle of Gaugamela in 331 BCE. Despite being outnumbered, Alexander's superior tactics and disciplined troops routed the Persians once again. Darius fled, but his empire was now firmly within Alexander's grasp. With the capture of Babylon and the subsequent conquest of Susa and Persepolis, the heart of the Persian Empire lay in ruin. As Alexander continued his eastward march, he sought to unify the diverse cultures under his rule. He married a Persian noblewoman, Roxana, and encouraged his officers to do the same, fostering a sense of unity among the Macedonians and Persians. This amalgamation of cultures, known as Hellenistic civilization, would have a lasting impact on the regions he conquered. But Alexander's insatiable ambition knew no bounds. He pressed on, crossing into the Indian subcontinent. The Battle of Hydaspes in 326 BCE pitted Alexander's army against the formidable Indian king, Porus. Despite fierce resistance, Alexander emerged victorious. However, his troops, tired and homesick, began to express dissent. Recognizing the limits of his conquests, Alexander reluctantly turned his gaze westward, beginning the arduous journey home. Tragedy struck in 323 BCE when Alexander's beloved horse, Bucephalus, died. Grief-stricken, he commissioned grand cities, including Alexandria in Egypt, to immortalize his legacy. But fate had other plans. A fever took hold of the great conqueror, and on June 10th, 323 BCE, Alexander's extraordinary journey came to an untimely end at the age of 32. Though his life was brief, Alexander's impact on the world was immeasurable. His conquests left an indelible mark on history, ushering in an era of cultural exchange that shaped the course of civilizations for centuries. From the humble beginnings of Macedonia to the grandeur of his empire, Alexander's legacy remains a testament to the enduring power of human ambition and the quest for greatness.